NBC Sports Radio, AM 1060, KDUS Tempe, Phoenix, and KSLX HD2 Scottsdale, Phoenix.
You are listening to the Lance J Radio Network on NBC Sports.
Ray, did your parents listen to The Temptations when you were growing up?
They sure did.
So, in the era of biopic movies, you have the Tupac movie, you have the Eminem 8 Mile movie. I love the old school biopic movies that didn't make it to the big screen, like the ones that are on BET at 3 in the morning. Mm-hmm. I love those type of movies. I was watching The Five Heartbeats. I was watching VH1 earlier in the week. And they did a back-to-back. Well, they did a triple. They did a Five Heartbeats, Temptations, then the one on the Jackson 5.
Wow, yeah. I missed that.
During this song, Papa Was a Rolling Stone on the Temptations movie, there's a montage of what's going on in the Temptations. Like, David Ruffin is getting high off of heroin and cocaine. The other guys are going to parties. One of them's cheating on his wife. It's just everything is converging at one particular time. It's a very, very good movie. Leon, who played David Ruffin, that was like an Oscar-worthy performance. And during this montage, they're setting up for this song, which is one of the classic songs of the Temptations, but not the original five, the David Ruffin era, but this is when Dennis Edwards was singing for the Temptations.
Okay.
The reason I start the show with this song, it's talking about LeBron James. LeBron James was a Rolling Stone. Wherever he laid his hat was his home. But when he leaves Cleveland, all he's going to leave them is with one ring and alone. You're listening to the Paragon of Sports Talk Excellence, the Lance J Radio Network, coming to you live from KDUS NBC Sports Radio Studios in sunny Phoenix, Arizona. I'm your host, the one and only James Lewis III. It's a pleasure to be with you on a Sunday evening with my co-host, Miss Congeniality herself, Ray Black. How are you doing this week, Ray?
I'm doing good.
Are you getting used to my stories to open the show?
Do I like your stories?
Do you like? Well, I said, are you getting used to them?
Yes, I am. I like your analogies. Yes.
Okay. We try to do something a little bit different, being that it's a hip-hop and music. You know, Temptations, the Delphonics, I mean, all that stuff is sampled by most of your elite hip-hop artists. And everyone is talking on Sports Talk Radio about LeBron James. And
yes.
The series was extremely anticlimactic. We were sitting here last Sunday night as Golden State blew through the Cavs in Game 2, winning that game by 30 points. I think me and you looked at each other, we were like, yeah, it's a wrap.
Yeah,
this series
totally
is over. So Game 3 and Game 4 really didn't go much different, much to the chagrin of Cleveland Cavalier fans. Game 4 was really, they just kind of laid down. Game 4 was not competitive. It was what is called a boat race in sports lexicon. It was not close. It was an obliteration. It was a mismatch. Leaving a lot of people very disgruntled and chagrined. But now we get into the drama, because that's just the game. The game is just the game. The game is that's only part of the television show. Now, the drama was that LeBron announced after the game that he had been playing with a broken hand. I don't know if you heard that.
I didn't hear that.
Apparently, he punched the wall after game one. So the game where he had 51 points,
yeah,
eight rebounds, and eight assists, and the J.R. Smith game,
right,
the infamous J.R. Smith
right,
game.
Right.
He punched the wall in the locker room after they lost that game. And since then, they floated this story out that he has been playing with a broken hand. Now, I've broken my hand before, and I'm not going to do a top five dead or alive on this, but there are a lot of things that you can't do with a broken hand. One of the things you can't do is sashay out of the post-game press conference with
your purse.
You cannot do that if you have a broken hand, first of all. He did this very long, protracted dapping up with his sons after game four. They did like the, you know, doing the electric slide, mm-hmm. did all of these. You can't do that if you have a broken hand.
Right.
And especially, you cannot throw the ball off the backboard to yourself and dunk on the whole team if you have a broken hand.
Right.
That's from my experience breaking my hand many, 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 many years ago. So we get into the theater. I mean, the games were the games. Now we get into the actual theater, the drama, the All My Children, the All My Cavs, the Days of Our Lives, the General Hospital, all of those things. We're in that era now. And we go into LeBron Watch 2018. Now, you're from L.A.
Yep.
You've identified as more of a Clippers fan than a Lakers fan, which is odd. I don't know why anyone would identify, especially someone that's from our era where the Clippers have been bad the majority of your life.
They have.
There are many teams that are going to be courting LeBron James, who has the opportunity to opt out of his contract. He has till June 29th, which happens to be my 40th birthday, to opt out of his contract. So if he opts out of his contract, he is an unrestricted free agent. He can go anywhere he wants to go. He can go to the Knicks. He can go to Houston. He can go to Los Angeles. He could go to Boston if there's the cap space. He could go back to Miami. He could stay in Cleveland. It's very probable that he's looking at a contract that's going to be a five-year contract for somewhere north of $200 million. It will be the largest contract in NBA history.
Wow.
What do you feel? Now, you're not a Lakers fan, but rumor, getting back to the theater, getting back to the television show, the dramatic effect, not the games, but the dramatic effect. People are saying that obviously LeBron James owns several homes in Los Angeles, as many wealthy individuals do, because right. it's a great place. It's a media center. The weather is beautiful. Mm-hmm. He has young children and beautiful wife and family. It's a great place to be. Not a diss to Cleveland. Nobody wants to spend their summer in Cleveland.
No.
Even our listeners in Cleveland are wishing right now that they could bat their eyes and teleport themselves to Miami or Los Angeles or somewhere on the coast. They don't want to be in Cleveland. Do you think that LeBron James would be a good fit for the Lakers? I know he's not going to the Clippers. I know you're a Clippers fan, but you're an LA person and you understand how LA is a Kobe Bean Bryant town. Now the legacy of Kobe Bryant is very palpable within the minds of millennials and people that grew up in our era, Generation X, Generation Y, the generation before us. It's a Magic Johnson and Kareem town. Can LeBron James come to the Staples Center and play for the Lakers and have that type of impact?
I think that he definitely could. I think he could lead the Lakers even probably to a championship.
You think that he can lead the Lakers to the championship?
Mm-hmm.
Now, what are you basing that on? I'm curious. I wasn't expecting that response from you.
I'm basing it on the fact that he led the Cavaliers to the championship, and he was pretty much, I mean, they weren't, he didn't have full squad.
Yeah, Kyrie, though.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, Kyrie Irving.
And I like Kevin, is it Love?
Kevin Love.
Yeah, I like him, too. But he led them. He had a little bit of help. But, I mean, he really is like a one-man, like, show. He just needs maybe one or two people with them.
Now, the Lakers have a lot of young talent. So they obviously have Lonzo Ball. Now, I'm a big fan. You and I have never had this conversation. We'll have to talk about it. I love LaVar Ball. I think that he's a genius. I think that he's brilliant. I love the fact that he pulled his kids out of school. He said, I'm not going to send my kids to the NCAA and let the NCAA exploit my kids. I'm going to exploit my own kids. Like, he pulled a full Joe Jackson and said, I'm going to manage my own kids' careers. We're going to have our own brand. We're not worried about suiting up for Nike or Adidas or all of that stuff.
Wow.
But you got Lonzo Ball, who is a high-value rookie. He had some bumps and bruises, but he averaged 10, 8, and 8. That's pretty solid for a rookie point guard.
Yeah.
You have Kyle Kuzma, who's a really good rookie. He averaged close to 16 points a game. He was a guy that was drafted late, and he flourished. You have Julius Randle. You have some really good young pieces, and the rumor is that LeBron James and both Paul George, who's also a free agent, will depart Oklahoma City and go to the Lakers. You think that that's a team that can immediately compete for a championship?
I mean, everything that you just said just, like, sounded real good.
All right. How do you feel? Because we were talking before the show. because you still have the death lineup for Golden State. What was your assessment, Ray, of Golden State and what they have and their ability to be a long-term dynasty?
I think they definitely are going to be a long-term dynasty. They have full squad and teamwork. They like each other. They're like brothers, and you can see their fire and their passion when they play, and they always keep a cool head and a good attitude, and I like that.
Now, you're a lady, and now this is, you know, most sports talk radio comes from kind of the barbershop commentary, the peanut gallery that guys have. Just, you know, we're all armchair quarterbacks. None of us are out there actually playing the games. We're just talking about people that can. But KD gets ripped pretty frequently for joining an already made team. A lot of people are saying that his championships are irrelevant. He's not in the pantheon, all of those things. As a lady looking at it from a different perspective, what is your view on KD leaving Oklahoma City and Russell Westbrook to go play for a loaded Golden State team?
Well, KD, I mean, he won MVP. So, I mean, although the team was already loaded, look what he brought to them.
So it doesn't, you don't look at that and say that you've taken the easy road out, because that's the narrative that I'm hearing on sports talk radio and on the news, that KD took the easy road out. He didn't want to fight and win those championships.
I don't think he took the easy way out at all.
No. I think he took the easy way out. I don't really like what he did. I mean, I get it, though. It's about money. It's about business.
It's
he
business,
has two rings. I just don't know. I mean, that's another argument for another day. I mean, it's... usually the narrative is you stick with the team, you get to the mountaintop, then after that you get a little bit older, you're allowed to click up and go win a championship somewhere else. For him to pull out of Oklahoma City, they almost beat Golden State a few years ago. I don't really like it, but KD is a two-time finals champion and a two-time finals MVP.
Yeah.
We'll be back after these messages with more of the Lance J Radio Network, NBC Sports Radio.